This is a summary of the CPIC dosing guideline for Ivacaftor and variation in the gene CFTR. This guideline was last updated in June 2017. Ivacaftor does not have a clinical effect in cystic fibrosis patients who do not carry certain class 3 variants in the gene CFTR. The guideline therefore recommends the use of Ivacaftor only in patients carrying at least one class 3 CFTR variant. Alternative therapies are recommended for patients who do not carry a class 3 CFTR variant. Variants in the gene CFTR can lead to the production of defective CFTR proteins, which are unable to transport chloride ions out of cells and ultimately cause cystic fibrosis. CFTR variants which cause cystic fibrosis can be categorized into different classes by the nature of the defect that they cause to the CFTR protein. The different classes are shown in this table, adapted from Table 1 of the guideline. Ivacaftor is approved for use in patients carrying certain class 3 variants. CFTR proteins with a class 3 variant are able to localize to the cell membrane, but have gating defects, so are unable to activate. Note that the efficacy of Ivacaftor can be affected by the presence of some other CFTR variants. For example, if a patient carries one class 3 variant and a class 1 or class 2 variant, which prevents the CFTR protein from localizing to the cell membrane, the clinical response to Ivacaftor may be reduced. Ivacaftor is currently approved by the FDA for use in patients carrying any of these class 3 variants. This list can be found in the supplementary information for this guideline and can be accessed using the link in the description below this video. There are around 1900 CFTR variants that can cause cystic fibrosis. Therefore, it is crucial that a patient's genotype is accurately identified. As such, this guideline is only suitable for use in conjunction with FDA-approved tests, which cover all variants listed in this table. This image is taken from the PharmGKB Ivacaftor pathway. A link to the original pathway is provided in the description below this video. Ivacaftor is metabolized in the liver by CYP3A enzymes. There are currently no data about any effects of polymorphisms in CYP3A on the metabolism of Ivacaftor. Ivacaftor interacts with CFTR proteins at the plasma membrane of epithelial cells. It stabilizes the open state of the CFTR channel and overcomes the gating defect caused by class 3 variants. The G551D allele is given here as an example of a CFTR class 3 variant. A clinical study has investigated the safety of Ivacaftor in cystic fibrosis patients who were homozygous for F508del, a CFTR class 2 variant. The study observed that these patients were unlikely to respond to Ivacaftor alone. This is possibly because the F508del variant prevents expression of the CFTR protein at the membrane. However, this study was not powered to detect a difference in the efficacy of Ivacaftor, so this result should be interpreted with caution. It should also be noted that Ivacaftor, in combination with Lumacaftor, has been approved by both the FDA and the European Medicines Agency for use in cystic fibrosis patients who are homozygous for the F508del allele. This combination therapy is not covered by the CPIC guideline, which is only applicable when Ivacaftor is administered alone. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for Ivacaftor. The G551D allele is used here as an example of a class 3 variant. Patients carrying at least one CFTR class 3 variant should experience significant improvements in clinical outcomes as a result of Ivacaftor treatment. These patients can be given Ivacaftor using the dosing instructions given on the product label. This is a strong recommendation. Patients who are not carrying a CFTR class 3 variant or are not homozygous for the F508del allele may have an unknown response to Ivacaftor treatment, as the use of Ivacaftor in these patients has not been studied clinically. Ivacaftor is not recommended for use in these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. patients who are homozygous for the F508del allele are unlikely to respond to treatment with Ivacaftor. Ivacaftor is not recommended for use in these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. The dosing recommendations for Ivacaftor can be found in Table 2 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. Please note that these recommendations were originally published in 2014, when Ivacaftor was only approved for patients 6 years and older who were carrying the G551D allele. Subsequent FDA approvals have broadened these recommendations to patients aged 2 years or older who carry any of the 33 approved CFTR class 3 variants discussed earlier in this video and detailed in the supplementary information of this guideline. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. This menu includes all CFTR class 3 variants which are currently approved for Ivacaftor treatment. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to Ivacaftor, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific genotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.